Pivot table in Excel is very powerful tool and very easy to handle. Believe me, if you are linked with reporting or analyzing data, this tool will be your best companion. In this video and in the upcoming videos, I will show you everything about pivot table from the basic level to advanced level, starting from the beginning. Welcome to ASPC Excel Guides. Where to use pivot table? Suppose I have this Excel data. In this data, I have 9 columns: date, segment, name, product, units sold, manufacturing price, sale price, gross sale, sales. We have few segments, few names, and 6 products. Suppose you have been asked to summarize the sales like this table. The table is very simple. We have to put the segments vertically and sales value will be plotted to this field. There are 700 rows, 6 products. It is difficult to sum up the data and type it. We will use pivot table. Go to Insert menu. In the Tables tab, we have a button as pivot table. Click this. Don't forget to select any single cell before clicking the data. If your cursor is in any blank cell and you click the pivot table button, it will ask you to provide the source data range. To avoid this step, select any cell within the data. A new small window opens. Create pivot table. The data range is selected. The dashed lines are showing the range selected by pivot table. Next is two radio buttons, new worksheet and existing worksheet. I will choose new worksheet. There is another checkbox, add this data to data model, which I will show you in another video. Click OK. Please note, there is a new sheet created and we have a pivot table structure here. And in the right side, we have pivot table field list. Let me show you this field list in details. There are column headers, which we are calling as fields in pivot table. In the below, there are 4 empty boxes: filters, columns, rows, and values. We can drag and drop the fields in any of these boxes, and the table will be formed accordingly. To understand where to drop the fields, let us check the table structure again. We need segments row-wise and products in columns. We also need to show the sum of sales values. Let us move to sheet 1, pivot table. We need segments row, so drag and drop the segment field here, like this. We get the segment names in rows. Now, we need products as column headers. Therefore, drag and drop the product column here in this column box. This box is for rows and this box is for columns. Now, we need sales value. We drag and drop the sales field here in the values box. Arrange the column width. Our data is ready. Let's suppose management asked to show this data for our employee Jones. We have a column as name, where all the employee name listed. Go to sheet 1, search for the column name. Basically, we were asked to filter the data for Jones. Drag and drop name field here in the filters box. We get a new row with a drop down button. Click here. Please note, all the employee name is available. Tick this option, select multiple items, and now select Jones from here. This is the data for Jones. This data can be arranged in this manner also. Clear the filters. Drag and drop the name field from filters level to row levels after the segment. All the employees are now showing segment-wise sales. Now, the table structure is not comfortable for me. It is displaying the sum of the sales value above. If we need the classic table structure, we can change this table structure. The steps are: go to Analyze tab, select this option button, go to Display tab, tick this Classic Pivot Table Layouts, click OK. Now the table structure changed. It is now displaying the employee names first and then the sum of their sales value. We have converted this table with minimum effort. Isn't it a good tool? This is just the beginning. We have lot more things to know in Pivot Table. Please like and click the subscribe button to get modern Excel tutorial notification. Thank you for your interest.